Across Yorkshire's moors and dales, the world's most famous vet set the benchmark for animal care. And James Herriot's legacy lives on. His former trainee, Peter Wright, has been a Yorkshire vet...
All right, fella, no one's shaking your head at me.
..for 40 years.
Many years ago, this is what my old boss taught me to use, and it's done the job for me very well over the years.
New life.
Fills me full of so much joy.
Now running a new Yorkshire practice, Peter's former partner, Julian Norton...
Hello.
..also upholds the Herriot ethos.
I'm feeling a lot better, thank you.
And in the foothills of the Pennines...
Come on, lad.
..at one of the country's busiest animal hospitals...
So cool.
..a new generation of town and country vets are following in their footsteps.
Shona just touched me through the cow, which feels very strange.
Feet, take one.
The vet teams have one common goal.
It's called the art of veterinary science.
I love it.
To help animals of all shapes...
..quicker than I was expecting.
..sizes...
Hello, dear.
..types...
Yeah, I'm on, big boy.
Ow!
..and temperaments.
Good boy, I said, not bad boy.
It's definitely not glamorous.
It smells like mouldy cheese or something like that.
But it's varied.
Come, Jake, I don't know whether I can.
It's rarely easy.
How did it escape?
But they continue the Herriot tradition.
They're a bit wild, the cattle over here.
Treating all creatures great...
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Chill, chill, chill.
It's one of these jobs where you need your porridge before you start.
..and small.
I need some glasses, he's so small.
Majesty of Yorkshire. A regal land, fit for a king. Pomp and ceremony doesn't always rule in these parts. But everywhere, there are crown jewels. While an Englishman's home is his castle, Yorkshire vet can spend a lot of time at the practice.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Cunningham.
Morning.
How are you doing, Peter? All right? You had a good ride in?
I bet you've got another action-packed day ahead of you, haven't you?
Plenty on as usual. Yeah.
Excellent.
There's a long list on that board to work through.
Blimey.
And sometimes it's a night tale. In Huddersfield, Matt's been called into the animal hospital, where a ewe who's struggling to give birth has just arrived.
It's middle of the night. I've rushed down here. We've got everything prepped up.
And in need of some help at such an unsociable hour, Matt's called on his queen.
That's it, Catherine. You just kind of almost half pull. That's it. Perfect there. I just sat down on the couch with a cup of tea and the call came in, so I've dragged my significant other, Catherine, with me to give me a hand should things go a little bit sideways.
We could just be sat watching TV and Matthew gets a call, so we have to, like, rush and get ready, get in the car and get straight off to where we need to be.
You got it?
Yeah.
Come on, missus. If I can, I want to try and lamb naturally, get my hands in and see if I can get all the lambs out without having to cut into them.
Come on, there you go.
I'm going to lift her straight on. Right, ready, Dan? 3, 2, 1. Oh, boy, she's a big lass, isn't she? Whoa. Right then, Dan. What's the story?
She's been doing about 4 hours.
Yeah.
No signs, not opening up.
No.
Thought it could be a breach.
Yeah.
Doesn't seem to be, so...
Crikey. I'll have a quick feel to what we'll be dealing with.
It should be twins.
Should be twins. All right, Kathy.
She's been doing pawing, crying, but there's been no developments. This is her third lambing and she's never had any problems before, so hope she does all right.
Matt has made a quick decision.
So, I've had a feel in that back end there, and everything is really tight. Something's gone wrong there, and the only option now is to go out that side door, and hopefully we're just in time for these lambs. All right, just get you numbed up, missus. Obviously, you know, this is a very stressful time for mum as well, and when things aren't going to plan, mum is just as much at risk as those lambs are. Fingers crossed, we're not too late. A cesarean is always a big risk for a sheep, and it's something we should never take that decision lightly. But in these situations, there's no other choice.
She's She seems to be doing all right. She's staying pretty still, which is good.
I don't want to incise into that stomach, which is one of the biggest risks when you're going. Because if they move and that scalpel blade cuts something that it shouldn't do, then unfortunately, it can swiftly turn into a disaster. Okay. Don't think these lambs are going to be small, Dan. So I'm just trying to push. There's a lot of fat there. I'm just trying to push. So there's the stomach, you see, and here's the fat. It's all sat at the wrong side for me. So I'm just literally having to work through intestines and... this is a tricky one.
In Kirby Moorside, Samantha is waiting anxiously at the practice.
Good girl, Gracie. You are. Yes, you are. Such a good girl.
Her two-year-old poodle, Gracie, has an appointment with Peter.
We noticed that her eyes started weeping, so I brought her in. She's my baby. She's a beauty. They're so gentle, caring, so loving. And we call her Gracie Bear because she's like a teddy bear when she hasn't been clipped.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And this must be Gracie, is that right?
Yes, it is. This is Gracie.
Hello, dear. How are you? Are you all right? Hey? And what's the matter? Have you had a poorly eye? Can I have a look at it? Oh, yes. This eye particularly, you can see, it's causing her a lot of discomfort. She's blinking all the time because that lower lid is rolling in. And the hairs are then rubbing on the eye itself. And that causes inflammation on the cornea, the window of the eye. So it's something that needs correcting. So what we're going to do is pull it back down to the position it should be, which is there. So we're going to take an ellipse of skin out below the lower lid to stop that eyelid rolling in over. Aren't we, dear?
It's better to have it done because of the discomfort for her. So she'll be a lot happier, so that means a happy owner. See you, Gracie Bear.
We'll look after you. She'll be a model citizen, I'm sure of that.
I'm sure she will. She might cry a little bit, but...
We'll look after her.
I know you will.
Go on, Gracie. It's all right, don't you worry yourself. She's a nice lady, really. This just relaxes her, because she's just a little bit tense, aren't you? Because your mother's abandoned you, hasn't she? This operation, it's almost like cosmetic surgery. It's a corrective procedure to pull this eye line back into the position that it should be so the hairs below the lower lid then don't rub on the eye surface itself. So you've got to get this operation just right.
But before Peter and Nurse Hannah have even begun the eye surgery...
Are we ready, Nurse?
Yeah, I think we are.
Peter's made a familiar oversight.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, taking me glasses out of my pocket. I've done that. I've got to put the bloody things on, though. Oh, God. I'm going to have to ask for assistance.
Would you like your glasses, Peter?
I would, please. I thought I'd done everything right, regimentally, but no. Forgot the glasses. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Right. OK to go ahead, Anna?
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
From now on, there's no room for any more errors.
One mistake here, when you're working close to the eye, it can be very, very serious indeed. So it's a very fine operation, this. There's no leeway for error in this type of surgery.
Coming up...
All right, fingers crossed. Let's see what we've got here.
It might not be Catherine's dream date, but there are lambs to save.
Catherine, there you go. Give it a good shake.
Hello.
And Julian's at the tailor's, unsure about his attire.
A warm day like this, you don't really want to be wrapped up in plastic, but it's important.
Don't complain. It's the first warm day we've had.
I know, I know.
At the hospital in Huddersfield, Matt's on the night shift.
In this particular case, they're all sat at the wrong side.
He's operating to try and save twin lambs after Dan rushed in his ewe.
It's like a... I've got to pull them up. There we go. There we go. There's the feet. All right, fingers crossed. Let's see what we've got here.
the quicker we get these lambs out, the better.
And although by day she's a lawyer, tonight Matt's girlfriend Catherine is his assistant.
We're alive, we're alive, we're alive, out we come. Catherine, there you go, give it a good shake. Give it a rubber shake, that's it. Pass it to Dan. And then come back really quick, come back really quick.
I've got it.
One out, time to get the second one. Tricky to find the second one, they're all in the wrong position. See there, let's get this back of that membrane off. Ugh. Membrane's off. Come on, little lamb. Got it, I've got it. I'll pass it straight to Dan. You've got it there. Right, passing it to you, Dan. You ready? There you go, Dan. Straight to you. I was concerned, given that she's been lambing for a while, that we were too late, but as soon as I felt that movement, it was game on. Get those lambs out and get them breathing, and I tell you what, they're looking happy.
Well done, Matt.
Oh, man, it was a bit tense there. I tell you what, that second one, Dan, it was just... It was literally like it wanted to come out the front end, never mind back end.
Right.
You know. All right, then, missus, let's get you stitched up. So I'm knitting everything together now. I want to get it off this table as quick as I can, because she's got two little twins to look after.
Yeah, they're in good shape. They'll be glad to have the mother back in a minute when he's finished putting her back together.
Stellar work from my assistant there. Catherine can come and do this with me again.
It's really great to help Matthew out and get stuck in, especially when it's a good outcome all round, so that's really good.
All right, then. That's everything sealed back in. Last stitch, little lady. Let's get you home. That's it, that's it, that's it. Catherine, let them legs go now. That's it. Ooh, that's it. Good girl. There you go. Do you want to see your babies? There you go. There you go. Good girl. Are yours? Right then, Dan. Let's give you a hand with them. OK, don't worry, you'll see them as soon as you get back.
They're keeping warm in the front of the car. It's a bit chilly tonight for them to be in the trailer. So we'll get Mum and them home safely now, hopefully. They're very happy.
Come on. Come on, girl. Good lass, good lass. That's it. Up you go. Right, Dan, let me know how they get on and no doubt I'll see you again soon.
Hopefully not, but yeah, I'll let you know how they get on.
It was absolutely great. It was great to see Matthew do it, and it was a lovely outcome, so lovely to see two live lambs.
Outcomes like this, mate, coming out in the middle of the night, all completely worth it. To see Dan drive off there with a mum and two healthy lambs,
brilliant.
So now the plan is to get home for a quick shower, finish off that cold cup of tea, and hopefully catch a few hours of Kip.
In Kirby Moorside, Peter's performing delicate surgery on Gracie the poodle.
What a fiddly little job this.
To correct the position of her eyelids.
It's got to be neat as well, because we don't want to spoil Gracie's beauty either. Operation which is close to the eye like this, where you're working with a very sharp scalpel, obviously you've got to proceed with caution, and hopefully we'll have got this just right, in that we'll have taken just enough off to correct the eye line. So far it's coming back into place nicely. One more stitch on this side and then we're done. I'm fairly sure that that eye line should be nicely in position now. Anna, what do you think?
Yeah, looks good.
Right, so if it's not right, it's your fault now, for sure. This eyelid was not curling in quite so much, so there's only a very small amount to take off here. And in some ways, that makes it trickier, because there's just a fine margin of error here. Right, here goes. When we saw Gracie in the waiting room and we're looking at her eyes, she was blinking all the time. She was in significant discomfort as the hair rubbed on the surface of her eye. So This is going to be massively beneficial. Gracie will now be able to carry on with the rest of her life, not having irritation on her eyes and potential risks of ulcers. So I'm fairly hopeful now that she'll be okay. Oh, Gracie. Where's your mother? She's here.
Gracie.
Who's that?
Gracie Bear.
Who's that?
Hello, baby.
You see, I told you you haven't been abandoned.
Oh, no. I knew you'd have that cone on.
We've had to do because if she brings her foot up, it's quite delicate surgery and she could soon do a lot of damage.
Yeah.
So, but I'm quite chuffed with the way it's gone. Well, you can see the eye line there is exactly where it should be.
Yeah, it's lovely. Brilliant.
You are very pleased to see your mother, aren't you?
Yes. She's
happy now. Well, what do you reckon, Gracie? Are you off home?
We're off to the pub. We're going to have something to eat.
That sounds good fun.
Yeah.
Well, I think I'll come with you.
Yeah.
Julian's on his way to Nigel Taylor's farm.
So today's job is a nice little job. It's some pregnancy testing on some cows. The Taylors are a really fantastic family, very traditional farmers. So it's a nice place to go, especially on a lovely sunny day like today. Hello. You all right? Sorry I'm a bit late.
Warm day like this, you don't really want to be wrapped up in plastic, but it's important.
Don't complain, it's the first warm day we've had.
I know. I don't complain,
right? Right, good, yeah, got the thing. Scanner, goggles. So we've got eight, have we, to do?
Yeah.
It's a nice number. So this scanner in my right hand is on top of her uterus now, so I can see exactly what's in there. I'm going to try and see if I can get a picture of this because it's really interesting. So can you see that those big white things that look like strawberries?
Yeah.
Are the cotyledons, which attach the calf to the placenta. So I can say without any doubt at all that this cow's pregnant. She's about a bit more than 3 months, actually, 3.5 months.
Nice.
That's a good start. I think she's pregnant, you know, but I think what we'll need to do is check her again in a few weeks.
Yeah, yeah.
If that's all right.
Yeah.
Because there's a little bit of fluid there, but it's really just on the cusp of what's possible. So we're going quite well. So far, everything's looking pregnant, which is good. It's going relatively smoothly.
But a Yorkshire vet should never count his chickens.
Come on, lass, that way. To go back inside. Come back. You always get one. She's off. Come on, lass. Go on.
When it comes to animals being a bit exuberant...
He is wicked, isn't he?
One species likes to act the goat more than most.
Whoops, oh dear.
But being so fun-loving can be a slippery slope to an unwanted appointment. At Cannon Hall Farm, Rob and Dave have discovered a problem.
One of our young female pygmy goats has got a broken hind leg. The poor thing's in pain. It's a nasty break. I've rung Matt and he's coming out to hopefully fix it, but I'm really quite nervous.
If the break's in the wrong place, it's 50-50 whether you can.
You all right, Matt?
Afternoon, you all right?
Matt. I'm really good.
How's things?
Well, we've put some vet wrap round and stabilised it as best we can. We're just hoping it's one you can mend.
Fingers crossed. Right, let's find a good space for her.
All right. Perfect.
How did it happen?
We don't know, Matt, really. We just came across it when we were feeding them. And, yeah.
They play pretty rough sometimes, don't they?
Yeah, yeah, they do bash each other and...
Ooh, yeah, it's a fracture straight across that bone there.
Yeah.
So the key's with the fracture stabilising the joint above and below the break. Hopefully, I'll be able to pot it. Unfortunately, some breaks should go to the just irretrievable. So, fingers crossed, we can get this little lady back on the mend. Right then, Rob, if you wouldn't mind just with your hand there, just holding her leg up like that for me.
Yeah, I've got it.
Like I said, often. Hey, up. We've got moral support there.
This is her best friend, actually, Matt, so she's obviously feeling concerned for her.
Oh, bless. Well, we'll have a pal back to her in no time, hopefully. Yeah, I'll just come up towards your thumb a little bit. Relax, relax. There we go. This will start hardening as soon as I've wet it, which I have, so now I've got to work pretty quickly to make sure that this doesn't dry out on me.
And we'll put her in a little isolation pen.
Definitely, yeah, because unfortunately we can't tell her that she needs to keep her legs still and she's got a cast on.
I really wanted red for Barnsley, Matt.
Did you? Well, I'll tell you what, next time. Yeah. Next time. I'll bring red next time. Relax, we're nearly done. We're nearly done. Beautiful. Right, I'm happy with that. Let's bob her back to a pen.
Yep.
The one good thing about breakages in younger animals is that they can heal quite quickly. However, it all depends on the break, because sometimes you can go, fix them up, pop them, and then you come to take it off and the joint's just a mess and you have to put them to sleep. So just keep up a pain relief from now, keep giving it daily injections, and then I'll see you back in 2 weeks and hopefully that bone will have started to set nicely then.
Brilliant, right. Thank you, Matt.
Yeah.
See
yeah.
you later.
Right. See you in a bit, bye.
Matt was really efficient with putting that cast on. It minimised Flower's pain, and I'm really hoping she'll be blooming again in no time.
Me too. Just got to wait, and then we'll know for sure she's going to be OK.
Coming up...
This is my pet tortoise called Henry.
The spotlight is on Julian's special visitor.
So if you go like that, look, it looks like he's going to do a song and dance routine.
Queen Jean heads for a tour of Grace Lane.
This is the waiting area. It's a bit... Swish, indeed.
We heard that.
And when Matt goes back to Cannon Hall Farm, it's a royal appointment.
I am a little bit nervous. I've never met royalty, never mind perform veterinary procedures in front of them before. It's like hair, check, shirt, check, fly done up, check.
On a glorious afternoon in North Yorkshire, Julian's at the Taylor's farm.
Go on, missus.
Where one of the herd doesn't seem keen to find out if she's in calf.
Go on, lass. Go on, you know where to go. She's also pregnant. That's good.
Right, let's go.
It's going relatively smoothly. We've had one escapee. And one that's having a wee on my Wellington boots. This is what happens when you're a vet, standing behind the cow. It's a bad place to be. And urine is just one of the things that can hit you. She's quite well on, I would say, probably at least 5 months. 100% so far.
You'd be able to tell if it was a boy for later on or not?
I can't even see whether it's got a willy yet, so... You need to do that at an earlier stage, actually. Right. Where you can see the whole of the fetus.
Right.
Whereas now, because this calf would be probably as big as maybe a, I don't know, a Jack Russell or a Spaniel size, it's too far in. She's not in calf, I'm afraid.
Has he got any cysts?
Just having a look. So the left ovary looks fairly normal. There's a follicle on there, but she's definitely not pregnant. To me, it looks like she'll come bulling in the next probably 5 days.
Well, I would leave it then and let nature.
Yeah. I would do, yeah. Just put with a bull would be the best thing.
That eye, bull has short legs.
I'm sure if he's keen, he'd be able to work a way around it. So this is the last one. This is
cow number 8, did he?
She looks like she's about 5 months pregnant.
Good.
It's been a nice little job, really.
6 cows in calf and 2 question marks against them.
Well, that's more in calf than I thought.
Right. It's nice to get these plastic trousers off. It's warm and it's sunny and it's very pleasant to be out in the lovely grassy fields of North Yorkshire enjoying the weather. So it's been a very satisfying day. Good, that's been successful, hasn't
yes,
it? You'll be pleased with today's.
Thank you very much. We'll just have to see those 2.
Yeah, I think they'll be all right, though.
Yeah, yeah. Cool.
Very good. Right, well, thanks for having me.
Much.
See you again.
Right.
Cheerio.
At Cannon Hall Farm, Matt's back to see Flower the goat, whose broken leg he treated.
It's time for the goat cast to come off. Now, unfortunately, sometimes things can go wrong when you remove the cast. If, for whatever reason, the body's not put a nice callus there to secure the leg, there's always a chance things haven't gone to plan.
So it's a big day for the little goat. But in fact, it's no ordinary day for anybody here. Rob and Dave have been nervously waiting for a very special visitor to the farm. Her Royal Highness, Princess Anne.
I'm a little bit nervous. I've never met royalty, never mind performed veterinary procedures in front of them before. It's like hair, check, shirt, check, fly done up, check.
But while Rob and Dave rub shoulders with royalty, Matt's got his goat to focus on.
Right, let's get sorted, shall we?
Let's just have a quick feel.
So I'm just feeling to see if there's any swellings that have developed while this cast's been on, and there isn't there. There's a bit of muscle weakness there, which you're bound to get, but hopefully, once we take that cast off, you can start getting used to using it again, and you can be running around with these guys.
Already feeling the pressure over whether the goat's leg has healed.
Right, that's it, perfect.
With Her Royal Highness heading his way, Matt's nerves are kicking in.
Get my tissue out and mop my brow. Hi, Anne.
Drip.
How much do you explain? How much do I talk? I talk a lot. When do I shut up? Who do I look at? You know.
This is Matt.
And when was the break?
Well, it was 5 weeks ago that the break happened, and it was one that it was just above the joint here, and it was clean straight across. So I was really quite pleased because you have to set the cast below the joint and above the joint, which is why, like, breaks and such above here, unfortunately, it's often not the best outcome. You've really got to hope that, you know, the body's done its job and you've got the top prize.
Are you listening, Dave?
Yeah, I'm hoping I'm going to get the same result in 3 weeks' time.
Time for the moment of truth. Right, there we go. I'm bobbing down. That's it. Hey, that's it. There we go. Oh. So I'm really pleased with that. I think that looks great. Everything's looking quite nice there, and
yeah, there's plenty of hard tissue there.
That's fine. Yeah, I'm happy with that. That's grand.
With Flower back on her feet, it's time for Her Royal Highness to continue her journey around the farm.
Thank you very much, Royal Highness. Thanks. Crikey, Moses. How did I do, Darrell?
Yeah, I think you nailed it.
Half of me just wanted to have a bit of a chat, in all honesty. See how she's getting on, you know. Hope she's had a good day.
Thanks very much.
Amongst the farmers of Thirsk, the King and Queen are Jean and Steve Green.
I hope we have many more years together.
Fantastic. That is lovely.
And today, Peter's arrived with their carriage.
Your Highness, can you come and sit in the back of the car, please?
Because he has a grand tour of his own planned.
I thought today you might like to come and have a look out at the practice where I'm working now.
Last time I was in Kirby Moorside, I was in the hospital having toe straight when I was 9.
So last time you were in Kirby Moorside?
Was 61 years ago.
61 years ago.
Oh, yeah,
okay. Yeah. It's a nice ride out.
It is, isn't it?
After the chauffeur-driven journey...
Thank you very much, my servant.
Well, you're very welcome, Your Highness.
It's time for this royal visit to begin.
No, then
I will. I'll come round, Steve.
All right.
I'll come and help you.
I'm all right, don't worry about me.
Right, this is the waiting area. It's a bit swish, isn't it?
We had, man. Good afternoon, young lady.
Can I introduce you to my boss?
How are you doing?
This is John.
Thank you very much. This is Mrs. Green. Nice to meet you.
This is Steve.
How are you doing, Steve?
All right. Thank you. Yeah. Pleased to meet you.
John's in charge here, and I just do as I'm told when I'm here. Like when I'm at your house, I just do as I'm told.
And if you don't, you get a good argument.
I do. Eloise and Cara are just sort of getting this animal ready to be sorted out.
This is Ruby, and she's got a rather large lymph node.
I'm glad it's on her and not me.
Now, this is your cup of tea. Look at this little fella here.
Oh, what's wrong with him?
That was a stray, and like what usually happens in these places, one of the nurses has given her a home.
Hello! Are you going to put your paw through?
You want to play, don't you?
Yeah. She's gorgeous, isn't she?
Right, shall we go a bit further? Now, this is the dog ward.
Yeah.
Hey, look, you're beautiful.
That one there had eaten a whole chocolate orange.
And, that would do him in.
There's a red light on there that says they're taking x-rays in there.
Oh. Yeah.
I mean, when you think back, going back to when you first came into Sinclair and White, compared with that, it's a lot different, isn't it?
Oh, it is.
Oh, aye.
Different altogether.
It is.
There was nothing, they were mixing portions.
Yeah, that's right, there was.
It's a grand place.
It's lovely, isn't it?
I like it.
It is.
I like it. Come on, Steve.
Yeah.
Of course, no royal engagement would be complete without afternoon tea.
Might be a bit hot, is it?
No, it's just right.
Is it?
I can sup it.
And some souvenirs.
I should do with Nicky mug.
You can keep that mug if you want one.
Can I?
Yeah.
Thank you. And I'll give Peter one to bring back to you with me and Steve on.
Well, there you go. It's a good swap, isn't it?
It's a good swap.
Yeah.
Make a good brew here.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
And it seems Peter's practice...
Thanks for bringing us, Pete.
..has the royal seal of approval.
I'm very impressed by it. It's a marvellous place.
I think it's absolutely fantastic. And Dabby Doodah.
In Wetherby, 6-year-old Noah and mum Michaela have brought a pocket-sized patient to see Julian.
This is my pet tortoise called Henry.
Henry means a lot to Noah. It just gives him something to focus on and to care for, doesn't it?
Yeah, I love him.
But recently, Noah's noticed some worrying changes in little Henry.
He's got sticky eyes and he won't eat.
He's been a couple of days not eating, just sleeping, his eye was stuck together. Don't seem himself at all, has he?
No.
I'm worried.
Hello, Henry. So, who have we got here then? This is Henry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have to say, he's the smallest tortoise I think I've ever seen. How old is he?
6.5 months.
He's quite dinky, isn't he? How... I need some glasses, he's so small. Is it just one eye where there's a discharge?
Yeah, it was like a white one, Noah.
Yeah, and he closed a bit and he couldn't even open.
I can see this eye, it is a bit closed already, isn't it? I'm just going to get a little scope to try with a magnifying glass to look in his eye. I'm just going to switch one of these lights off just to make it go a little bit darker. I think this is the smallest eye that I've ever looked in, so... This is a first for me, but it looks OK from what I can tell. Looks like he's enjoying the limelight. So if you go like that look, it looks like he's going to do a dance, a song and dance routine. The greatest showman.
I think he likes the attention, don't you?
He does, yeah, he's in the spotlight. Right, so back to normal light.
It looks like he's got a simple conjunctivitis, so that hopefully should be easy to treat. The main problem we're going to have is the eye drop. Each drop is going to be about as big as his whole head. So it's going to be a bit of a mess, I think.
Your job, Noah.
Yeah, watch carefully, yeah.
Is to put these drops in, right. So...
this is going to get messy.
It could get messy. So a blob of drop, OK, looks as big as this. So that is going to be way bigger than his little eye, almost as big as his whole head. So when this lands on his eye, he'll pull his head back in. Oh, no, it isn't done. And that will slowly, it'll dissolve. And you just need to do that about twice a day. Can you do that?
Yeah.
There we are. Give him his rocket back. His rocket leaf, that is not rocket mode of transport. Shouldn't put a tortoise on a rocket. And that should fix him, I think. And keep him nice and warm. It'd be quite nice to check him again in a week or two's time if he's...
yeah.
If he's all right, just be nice to see him again.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Very good, yeah. Thanks for coming, nice to see you. And good luck with the eye drops.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, cheerio. I think Henry was actually the smallest patient that I've ever treated. His eye was even smaller, so it was quite hard to get a very accurate assessment. But hopefully he's going to be OK.
Still to come...
Morning, Dan, you all right?
Will, Matt and Catherine receive good news about the lambs they delivered.
Just so excited to see them today and see how they've got on.
And Peter's on the glorious Yorkshire coast, hoping to see an amazing Gracie.
How was those eyes? Hey, Gracie, come and see the nasty man.
Since Peter operated on Gracie the Poodle's problematic eyelids, she's been recovering in Whitby with Sam and her son Adam.
Come, Gracie, good girl. Gracie Bear, come on.
And Peter's taken time out of a trip to the North Yorkshire coast to take a look at his patient.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
OK, how are you?
I'm very well, Sam. How was those eyes? Gracie, come and see the nasty man.
Come on.
Come and see me. That's lovely. I'd rather not remember him. And I don't associate him with anything nice. Oh, dear. It's all right. It's all right. I think those have come out very nicely. And those eyes have restored a form of beauty.
Gracie! Good girl! To have her back normal, running around, happy, instead of scratching at her eyes all the time, it's just brilliant.
Well, I've got to say, Sam, I'm very pleased with how things have turned out, and it's absolutely great for us as vets to see the end result of our handiwork and then to be able to restore her so she can get on with what she wants to get on with, like running up and down this beach.
Yes, she's loving it.
And on a day like this, in beautiful North Yorkshire at the coast, and to see Gracie as she is, it's just as good as it gets.
Across Yorkshire, Julian's smallest ever patient, Henry the Tiny Tortoise, is back at the practice with six-year-old owner Noah and his mum Michaela.
I saw him last week to have a look at his eyes. I was sticky and quite sore. So hopefully he's doing okay.
Noah's done a really good job putting eye drops in on a morning and on a night. I haven't really done anything.
He's like been moving around a lot. So sometimes when I have to do his eye drops when it's bedtime, he's like, nope, I'm running away.
Henry?
Hello, Noah.
How are you doing?
Good.
Here he comes on his astroturf. Have you been able to manage with the drops? It was a difficult task, I guess.
It was good.
You managed to get it in?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
And you did everyone, didn't you?
Yeah.
Excellent, good lad. Oh, even from here, I can tell that looks a lot better. It was this one that was sore, and it looks totally normal now. It's exactly the same as the other one. Bright and shiny, clear and wide open, looking around for new adventures. Hey, isn't that right? I'm pleased with him. I'm impressed with Noah. Putting drops into a tortoise's eye is difficult, even in a normal tortoise, but in a miniature one like this, it's really, really difficult. So maybe you're going to decide to be a vet in future. Do you think that's the plan?
Yeah.
Cool. Excellent. The next generation. Maybe a tortoise vet, maybe. Right then, Henry, you can go back on your astroturf, I think. Brilliant. So, I don't think we need to see him again, sadly.
Really pleased. Really, we're happy, aren't we?
Yeah.
That is all right now.
Brilliant. Thank you for bringing him back. Yeah, lid on, don't let him jump out. See ya.
Thank you.
Bye, Noah. Henry's looking an awful lot better. His little eyes are bright and gleaming and sparkling. There's none of the cloudiness that was there last time. No discharge and certainly no pain. He looks in great shape, really. So I think the future's looking bright for Henry and Noah.
Recently, when Matt performed an emergency C-section on a struggling sheep, he was assisted on the late-night call by his girlfriend, Catherine.
It's such a risky procedure for the ewe, and you never know what the ultimate outcome's going to be, so we've come to Dan's spot today to see the final result and to show Catherine the lambs.
I'm just so excited to see them stay and see how they've got on.
Morning, Dan, you all right?
Morning, Matt, you all right?
Hi.
How are you getting on? Right,
yeah, yeah, she's doing really well. Stitches come out a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
She's happy and ready to turn out today, I think.
Yeah, she's looking well. You can see them lambs. They're a fair size, aren't they?
No, they're a good size. She has a favourite. One seems to get a bit more than the other, but there you go.
Let's get cracking. Let's get her out. They got some face on them. There you go.
There you go.
Oh, this is a heavier one. I can't believe that. It's just been a few weeks, and look at the size of them now. Seeing them today is just brilliant.
Oh, man.
This one wants to escape.
In they go. One. Oh, stay there, Chief. Two. Straight on. Come on, Mum. There you go. There you go. There we go. Mum's always the one afterwards you're the most worried about, and it's amazing to see how well she looks. That wound has healed up so well, and she's come back bouncing. Right, team, you ready? Out you go. Just slow off the mark.
Don't want to go.
Come on. Come on.
It's nice to get them out in the fresh air. They're better outside than in, on God's green grass.
I love it, all the pals come to greet them as well.
Oh, that's so nice.
This is something that, you know, I see all the time, and it never gets old. It's brilliant to see, and I love the fact that I can share it with Catherine.
And that's next Tuesday, New at 8. This Thursday sees the start of a brand new Channel 5 original drama based on the gripping detective books by P.D. James, Dalgleish. Cannot wait. Next tonight, a new business venture and a surprise birthday party. The Owens have quite a bit to celebrate in our Yorkshire farm.